So what's new in AwareIM version 9.0? It may not look so, but a lot. Starting with the new Java. AwareIM now uses Java 17, but it will work with any later version of Java as well. It will not work with the earlier versions. This is of course only relevant for Linux and Mac users, as AwareIM ships with Java 17 for Windows. AwareIM now uses the new version of the Kendo UI library, and some of the features of version 9 is integration of some of the new widgets and features of this great library. New Kendo UI comes with a bunch of new themes. There's quite a few of them. But in fact, only four themes are significantly different. Bootstrap, Classic, Default, and Material. The rest are color variations of these four basic themes. For existing applications, AwareIM tries to match the old theme to the closest new one, but some minor stylistic changes may be required. So let's go through the new features of AwareIM 9.0. Some of the new features have been covered in separate video tutorials, so I will only briefly mention them and refer to the corresponding video for more details. One such feature is filters, query filters. Filters have been redesigned. And some new filters incorporated. Please watch this video tutorial for more details. Another feature is support for tiles that can be used in dashboards. Here we have tiles in the CRM sample application. And here they are in the issue resolution sample application. And here they are in the library application. Tiles are defined in a visual perspective. You can use the predefined tiles or create your own. For more details, please refer to this tutorial. Another feature is support for special display and editing widgets for standard queries, like these ones here. Or here. There is a new property called widgets for display and editing that allows you to set this up. For more details, please refer to this video tutorial. There have also been multiple improvements made to charts. There have been a few new chart types added, and many existing ones now have more capabilities. This is all explained in this video tutorial. There are some improvements in the integration of AwareIM with Google Maps. Most important one is that you can now control which markers are displayed on the map. This is explained in detail in this video tutorial. Speaking of the new widgets in the Kendo UI library, let me show you some of them integrated in AwareIM. The first one I wanted to talk about is the button group widget that is now available for text attributes with fixed number of choices where other values are not allowed. So for such an attribute, you can now pick a button group widget, which looks like this. We can see these widgets here, or here. This widget is useful when you have space in your form, and it's preferable to a combo box because you only need one click to select rather than two. Another new widget is now used for any attribute of the duration type. We can see it in action in the CRM sample application. So let's go to the list of communications. And here we can see the duration widget. We can set hours and minutes independently and even use predefined durations. We can set up properties of the duration attribute using format here. And on this dialog, we can specify which columns will be available for the duration, minimum maximum values and step, and also identify shortcuts, predefined values displayed at the top of the widget and accessible via a single click. In version 9, we have also added support for worksheets. Worksheets help developers keep track of their development progress and the issues involved. This feature is most probably relevant to really big systems with lots of business objects, rules, processes, and queries. Let me show you how this feature works. There is a new node in the tree called Worksheets. And when we select New, we can give it a name and description as usual. We can now add a work item to the worksheet. And in doing so, we have to select the type of the element, business object, and then specify some nodes. Or we can quickly drag and drop the element to the worksheet. Once the work has been started, we can change the status of the item to in progress. And then to complete it. You can quickly open the element by clicking this button here. Or you can automatically add all the configuration elements that reference the selected one. So all elements that have anything to do with the custom object have been added to the worksheet. A few changes have been made to the left menu. First of all, there are now two variations of the menu style. The old one called Classic, which looks like this. And the new one called Modern, that looks like this. This setting is defined in the properties of the corresponding visual perspective. Also, a new command has been introduced called Toggle Visibility of the Left Menu. This menu command can be added to the top menu to switch visibility of the left menu. This is the command. And this is how it works. So it just shows and hides the left menu. This is different from the slide in left frame command that slides in the menu and then automatically hides it when the selection has been made. Let's replace the command that toggles visibility with the one that slides in the left frame and see how it works. There is no left menu now, and then we click on this button, the menu slides in, and when we select an operation, it automatically hides the menu. By the way, the slide in command has been improved. It no longer hides itself when a folder item has been selected. Some of the new features of the Kendo UI library for the scheduler and tree widgets have been integrated into ORM. The scheduler can now have a yearly view. We can see it in the CRM application if we go to the company diary. And here we have the monthly view, but there's also a yearly view where appointments are shown like that. Moreover, it is now possible to specify how many months to show, so it's possible to have a 6-month view or 18-month view. This is done here in the properties of the yearly view. There were a few improvements in trees, but only for multi-column trees that show one type of object. We can see an example of such a tree in the Sales Portal application. So we open the Team Structure menu item of the Sales Portal application, and here we can see a tree of team members with group leaders. The improvements include support for images, as you can see here, support for item display rules. You can see that group leaders are shown in blue. Trees now support checkboxes so that they can be used in the pick from action. Grouping of operations on records is now supported. You can use business object groups when defining trees. And for fully expanded trees, filters and sorting are now supported as well. Another feature integrated in ORM is support for groups inside combo boxes. This is shown in the issue resolution application. If we create a new issue and look at the assign to attribute, we can see that the choices are grouped by department: human resources, IT, marketing, and so on. To configure support for groups, we go to the issue object, then open the edit form, select assign to. We can see the new grouping property here, where we can specify the attribute to group by. Another feature is support for choices in presentation rules. If you have an attribute with choices, sometimes you want to display less choices on a particular form rather than the entire list. You can now do this using presentation rules. So if we select an attribute with choices like status, go to presentation rules, we can define a rule with optional condition, and then here there is a new entry called choices. And on this dialog here, we can specify which choices will be available on that particular form only. When defining images for icons, you can now use not only Font Awesome, but the LineIcons font as well. Here we have the Font Awesome icons. And here we have line icons. There is a new absolute positioning flag that is supposed to deal with the problem of tall controls in a form. Let's have a look at the form of a staff member object. It includes a picture of a staff member, and this picture obviously can be very, very tall. So if we select this attribute, we can see that the absolute positioning flag is turned on and the form looks quite smooth. If we turn this off, let's see what happens. So when we go to a staff member, we can see that there's a large gap between this control and that control. And the gap is as wide as the picture itself. so the absolute positioning flag helps you deal with this issue. You have to be careful, though, in how you use this feature. If you want to put something underneath a tall control, you have to make sure that you position it at the same distance from the tall control. In previous versions, if an object was being created, you could not start a process from the form of such an object. The rationale was that you should not be able to operate with an object that hasn't been created yet. However, there are cases where you may want to start a process which does not have anything to do with the object being created. For example, a process that prepares choices for the object. So now there is a new flag that allows you to have an operation on a form of a new object. This is the flag here. It is a developer's responsibility to make sure that the operation does not involve the object being created. There are a few other improvements in version 9.0. Let me go through them quickly. In an HTML editor, you can now scale images and control which tools are available. When you use the display question action, you can now control which strings will appear on the dialog, not just yes or no, by specifying yes name and no name keywords for the action. Calendar widgets can now have a classic or modern look and feel. There is a new compact size flag for standard queries. This flag tries to make the row height in the query as compact as possible. And finally, there is a force popup keyword that can be used with the enter new and edit actions for applications that use the single tab mode, usually mobile applications. In the single tab mode, all forms and queries are displayed in a single tab. There are no pop-up windows. However, in some cases, it may be useful to display a pop-up provided that it fits the screen. The force pop-up keyword allows you to override the single tab mode. There are also a few other improvements. For a complete list, please see the release notes.